This video tutorial I will explain Java messaging service using Spring Boot and RabbitMQ, which is running on Amazon AWS EC2 instance. Here you can see Amazon AWS console, and here you can see this particular instance is running, and copy this IPv4 address, which is public, and using Putty software I am logging inside the EC2 instance. Using this particular command, I am starting the RabbitMQ server, and it is started successfully. Copy this public DNS name and here you can see the RabbitMQ UI, and username and password is guest. RabbitMQ uses 5672 port, and this port should be public. That we have to configure in Amazon EC2 instance. Copy this port number. And we have configured. Here you can see the client 1, which is the producer, which creates the message and sends the message to the queue. Here you can see the client 2, which is a consumer, which consumes the message from the queue. And once the message is consumed, it acknowledges back to the queue. In this example, we are using RabbitMQ server, which is running on Amazon EC2 instance. Here you can see the publisher, which published the message to the exchange. And exchange routes the message to the queue. And from the queue, consumer consumes the message. To publish the message, we are using Springboot JMS producer application. And to consume the message, we are going to use Springboot JMS receiver application. We will see that. Here you can see two eclipses. In one of the eclipses, you can see Springboot JMS producer application, and in another eclipse, you can see Springboot JMS receiver application. First, we will see Springboot JMS producer application. Here you can see Springboot JMS producer application with the folder structure, and here I have opened pom.xml file, and here I have included the dependencies of Springboot starter web and Springboot starter AMQP. This is related to RabbitMQ. Here I have defined the class RabbitMQ configuration, which is a component, and here I have defined topic exchange name as message underscore queue underscore exchange, and here I have defined the queue name as message underscore queue, and when Spring Boot application starts, it creates a queue object, topic exchange object, and binding object, and here I am binding a queue with exchange with this routing key. And also it creates a connection factory object based on this given configuration. The host name we have to provide, the public DNS name of Amazon EC2 server, and port number is 5672 and username and password is guest. Here you can see the Amazon EC2 server DNS name, which you can get it from here. Here I have defined the class application, which is a Springboot application, which implements a command line runner interface and provide implementation of run method. Using a convert and send method of rabbit template object, I am sending this message to RabbitMQ queue. This convert and send method, which converts Java object to AMQP message and send it to the default topic exchange. Then topic exchange route the message to the queue. And Spring Boot automatically creates a connection factory and rabbit template, which reduce the amount of code you have to write. Here you can see RabbitMQ console. Click on Queues tab. And currently there is no queue is there and no message is there. Now I am going to start this Spring Boot application. And Spring Boot application is successfully started and one message has been sent to the queue. We can check. And here you can see message underscore queue is created and in that one message is there. Click on this. And here you can see one message is there. Click on get message. And here you can see the payload. The payload is hello from RabbitMQ. That is what we have sent. And the queue name is message underscore queue and that is what created. And exchange name is message underscore queue underscore exchange. This name. Next, we will see how to consume this message using Spring Boot consumer application. Here you can see Spring Boot JMS receiver application with folder structure. And here I have opened pom.xml file. And I have included the dependencies of Spring Boot starter web and Spring Boot starter AMQP. And in application.properties file, server port I have specified as 9090. So when this Spring Boot application starts, it uses 9090 port. Here I have defined a class RabbitMQ configuration, which is a component. And here I have declared a topic exchange name as message underscore queue underscore exchange. And here I have declared a queue name as message underscore queue, and when Spring Boot application starts, it creates a queue object, topic exchange object, and binding object. And here I am binding queue with exchange with this routing key. And also it creates a connection factory object based on this given configuration. And here we have to provide a host name as EC2 instance public DNS name. And port number is 5672 and username and password as guest. Also, it creates a message listener adapter object based on the given JMS receiver. and also it creates a simple message listener container object based on connection factory, queue name and listener adapter. And here we are registering a JMS receiver with a message listener container to receive the messages. Next we will see JMS receiver. Here I have defined a class JMS receiver, which is a component, and it has a receive message method. Whenever queue has any messages, the message listener container will call this receive message method and pass the message, and this method will receive the message. Here I have defined a class application, which is a Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application, and here you can see it consumed the message, and before that one message was there, and currently zero message is there because the message is consumed. Next we will send one more message. Message has been sent. We will check in consumer log, and here you can see the message is received. We will send one more message. Stop this. Message has been sent successfully. We will check in the consumer log. And here you can see the message has been received. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.